little guitar riff. You can't even sing it so fast. Just that's what happens when guys can play too good.
The song was a
pretty woman, the kind I like to meet, pretty woman.
I think Pretty Woman is maybe the greatest rock and roll song ever written. It's got a great beat. It's got the great hook riff, that down, 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 down. There's a good story to the song. Great bridge that's a whole different melody that, you know. Pretty woman, stop a while.
Blessed with a tenor voice of uncommon beauty and sensitivity, Orbison crooned his rocking.
That is the extremely talented and sexy Chris Isaak, but there is really not that much wickedness to this small town boy. Chris takes us back to a small Stockton, California beginnings where he reveals his very strange first job and gets a key to the city.
Hi, Access Hollywood. I'm Chris Isaak, digging you from afar.
And we're digging you, Chris, as we accompanied the singer on a recent visit to his hometown in Northern California. Chris went home not only to perform for his friends and family, but also to accept a very special award.
It gives me great pleasure to present to Chris the key to the city of Stockton.
Somebody asked me, said, well, what's the key to the city mean? What does it really do anything? Makes me happy.
He should be. After all, this small town boy did make his dreams come true by becoming a successful rock star.
No,
thanks to a sultry 1991 hit Wicked Game, and with a little help from supermodel Helena Christensen, Chris Isaak has become a household name. On hand to witness this special day were the proud parents of their homegrown hero.
We're just thrilled to death, right?
My dad is just going, where are we gonna eat afterwards?
So off to eat we went. After a couple of wrong turns, our first stop down memory lane was the local bakery, Geneva, where Chris was bound to bump into some familiar faces.
You ever see my mom come down
here?
She
comes in quite often, yeah. I've known her for years, too. Remember when you was in grammar school with Woodrow Wilson?
Yeah. Wow, you remember?
Yeah, we were roommates at your mom.
I can't get by with anything in this town.
No, you can't. Not in this town, you don't.
After devouring a loaf of his favorite focaccia, Chris showed us what this small-town boy did before he hit the big time.
I had all kinds of different jobs. I worked at a funeral home. I was kind of a greeter. You come to the door, and I'd say, who are you here to see? And then you'd say, Mr. Jones, and I'd say, follow me to slumber room A. But they weren't slumbering. You could have played a coronet right in their ear and they wouldn't get up.
They did a bad, bad thing.
Next stop on the Chris Isaak local tour was Stag High, Chris's old high school. Even though Chris says he wasn't the smartest kid in school, he was definitely the most popular.
At the time I was in high school, I was driving a 46 Chrysler. People used to like my car. They used to want to borrow it to make out in because the back seat was big as a couch, man.
And the final stop before Chris's performance that evening was, appropriately enough, the music store where this musician used to hang out.
Aunque el mundo se ponga, nos tendremos que amar.
Now everyone at home, sing along.
Playing for the people in this store was impromptu, but how does he feel about performing for the people he grew up with?
I saw all the press they had in the paper, and I never rehearsed because we had the same guys for like 15 years. We know all the songs. And I actually called the guys and said, we got to rehearse. I'm nervous. I said, we're going back to my hometown. We can't make mistakes.
Come showtime, fans and friends alike were eager to see the former Stockton resident finally come back to his roots.
I'm very excited. I've been a fan of Chris's since I was 4 years old.
He's my Elvis. What can I say?
Well, he has the hair thing going.